Hey guys, it's Janice. Welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to show you the new iPadOS 18 customization features, as well as how to customize your own iPad with shortcut icons and some of my favorite widgets. Make sure you've updated to iPadOS 18 by going into your iPad settings, then software update. Let's get started by going over the new customization features in iPadOS 18. When you tap and hold on the screen, there is an edit button that pops up, and when you tap on it, a drop-down menu appears. The first option on the menu is Add Widget, which works the same as in previous iPadOS versions and pulls up a menu to browse through widgets that you can add to your screen. This drop-down also has a brand new customized feature with several options. You can now apply light or dark mode tints to your icons and widgets, regardless of your system being light mode or dark mode. And you can now also add a color tint using the sliders or eyedropper tool to select a color. You can also change the size of your icons in this menu. Selecting large will also remove the icon labels. The last option in the drop-down menu is Edit Pages, where you can quickly view and access all the pages you have on your home screen, as well as drag and drop the pages to reorder them. With the new update, you can now also place icons and widgets almost anywhere on your screen, so you have a bit more flexibility with your layout, especially if you prefer a more minimal look. Another new customization feature is the ability to resize widgets just by dragging the corners. This only works on widgets that come in multiple sizes of the same style, and you will see a rounded line at the corner if the widget is compatible with this feature. While you're not in edit mode, you can also long press on the widget and tap on these little icons to change the widget into the corresponding sizes. Another new feature in iPadOS 18 is Control Center customization. You can now switch between multiple tabs in this control center, including your main controls, a music tab that shows you what's playing, as well as a connectivity tab for things like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data, etc. In terms of customization, you can now add and remove controls including shortcuts and third-party app controls. You can reorganize them and also change their sizes by dragging the corners. I personally haven't really customized the control center except for removing some controls and adding some shortcuts of my own, so you won't see too much customization here. Now let's go over how to add a custom icon for any application on your iPad. Don't forget to grab the free download in the box below if you want to follow along with the same emoji style icons, as this is what I use for the main dock on my home screen. For this tutorial, I'll be changing this Spotify icon in the dock to match the rest. To start off, open the Shortcuts app on your iPad. This is a native application that your iPad should already have, but if not, just head to the App Store and download it. Now I highly recommend making a folder to organize your shortcuts, since you'll probably be making custom icons for a lot of apps, and it could get really messy if you never sort them. So tap on the folder icon at the bottom here to create a new folder and just call it Open Apps or something similar. Then, when you're in the folder, tap on the plus sign at the top right to create a new shortcut. Make sure to tap on the shortcut name to rename it. I usually just put in the name of the application. On the right here is the list of actions you can choose from, and there's one simply called Open App. Once you've tapped on it, the action will show up on the left. Tap on the app text, and from the drop-down menu that appears, select the app that you want the shortcut to open, which in my case is Spotify. The next step is super important if you don't want the shortcut notification banner to pop up when you open the app from the home screen. Search for the Nothing action in the search bar, then drag it above your Open App action. Once you're done that, tap on this information icon on the right here, then add to home screen. If you want to choose your own custom icon, check the photo option, then tap on either choose photo or choose file. Select your image, then tap on add and it'll appear on your home screen. If you're deleting the original app icon, make sure that you're selecting remove from home screen and not delete app. So that's how you create a custom app icon. The bad news is you basically just do this for every application you want a custom icon for. So it's a slightly tedious process, but the customization can be fun and it's worth it in the end. Now let's move on to widgets and what I've been using recently. To add a widget, all you have to do is tap and hold on the screen until the Edit button comes up, then tap on Add Widget from the drop-down menu. Widgets come from a variety of applications. If an application has a widget, it'll show up here. The first one I like to use is ZenFlipClock, which is just a very simple flip clock with a mini calendar in some of the sizes. This is one of those widgets that you can drag to resize. You can also tap into the app itself. It has a clock and a timer. And if you tap on the screen, you can also select from a few basic color schemes. Some of them are paid, but I only use the free versions. Speaking of calendars, I've also been enjoying this free one from an app called Minical. I prefer the look of it compared to the native calendar app, and what's great is that it actually integrates with your Apple and Google calendars, so all the same events show up. The next widget I use is MD Clock, which comes in a lot of different styles. I did pay the one-time fee for this a couple years ago since I wanted the animated 8-bit widget, and it's probably the only widget that I use from this app. It comes in a lot of different character styles, but I always come back to this one called Tang Bao. This is again one of those widgets that you can drag to resize. Definitely swipe through the rest of the widget styles in this app because there are so many to choose from. The next few widgets are from iScreen. This is a freemium app, and so far I'm only using the free version since there is quite a large variety of widgets you can get just by watching some 30-second ads. One of my favorite ones is a control panel called X Panel. It comes in a few different styles. You can put your name on it, add a photo on it, and of course customize the colors. Once you save your widget, it'll show up in your widgets tab within the app where you can see all the different ones that you've saved sorted by size. For iScreen widgets and similar applications, you will need to add a generic small, medium, or large widget onto your home screen, then select a specific one from your saved list. Another widget that I really like is the transparent Polaroid stack, which you can find under the Flip Album widget. Make sure to choose the Polaroid style, then add whatever photos you like into it. To set up the transparent background, tap on the transparent background option here. You'll see a screen like this where you can upload a blank homepage screenshot, which the app will use to set the widgets against to make it look transparent. Just go to your home screen, tap and hold to bring up edit mode, then swipe left to get to a blank page and take a screenshot. Go back into the app and upload this screenshot. Once you have this set up, tap on the transparent background again and choose where you want your widget to sit. Save it again, then add the iScreen widget to your home screen and you should see your widget blend into your wallpaper. Another widget that I really like is the badge, which I created a yellow star out of and put it on a transparent background. I also recommend the Mac panel widget, which is a larger widget that shows information about your device. I'm also using this sticker widget that has these very cute 3D options, such as this bunny, which I set against a transparent background. And lastly, the photo wall, which you can turn into a large record player to display your photos. Next up is a very, very similar app to iScreen called Mico, which is a freemium app, and I'm also only using the free version. I'm not kidding when I say there is so much to browse and play around with, so what I'm showing you is just the tip of the iceberg. This is where the smaller record player comes from, as well as this medium camera widget, both of which display photos. And they also have a very fun record badge that has an animated background and displays a photo of your choice. The next widget is MD Vinyl, which is a music player app that connects to your Spotify or Apple Music. It comes in a few color themes and displays the cover of the album or song that you're listening to. The widgets come in a few sizes and styles as well, but this is the one that I usually use. Another app that I've been using is MD Blank. I really like this one for the fuzzy clock they have. You can customize the colors quite extensively to match whatever theme you have going on. Another one is iBoard, which shows your device info as well as weather and calendar information if you want. And similar to iScreen, they also have this cute Polaroid one, which you can customize the colors of and even add a cute clip to the top of the Polaroids. You can tap to flip through and you can also resize it to make it a string of Polaroids. The only issue with this app is that you can't set a transparent background on the iPad version of the app, whereas you can on the iPhone. So what I did was just import the blank homepage screenshot and position it the best I can to make it look somewhat transparent. Next is Widgetsmith, which is what I use for adding other small, medium, and large photo widgets. But honestly, you could probably just use any of the three previous apps I mentioned to add photo widgets. So I'm not really gonna go into too much detail, but it does have a very simple interface if you're interested in using this for your photos. Next is DTD Sounds, which is a timer application that I really only use for the colorful motivational widgets it offers. If you go into the app itself, it is a very cute focus timer with some interactive elements on the screen. And when you exit the app, the widgets sometimes change as well, so that's all I use it for at the moment. The last widget I want to go over is the Reminders widget that I've been using for quite a long time. This is from the Reminders app on your iPad, and I use this to show positive affirmations or any quick to-dos that I've added to the Reminders app through my digital planner. Just create and name a new list in your Reminders app, choose the icon and color, and add in the text that you want. Then add the widget to your home screen. You can tap on it to choose the list that you want displayed. If it's an actual to-do list, you can also tick things off through the widget. The very last thing I'm going to go over is how to set up focus modes that change your wallpaper and home screen setup depending on which mode you're in. The bad news is you will have to set up a new wallpaper and home screen page for each focus mode. So for instance, if I don't have a focus mode turned on, you can see my slow mornings, cozy work, and wind down home screens as individual pages one after another. As time consuming as it is, create a new page setup for each focus mode you want, and also set new wallpapers if you want to change that as well. Now go to your settings, tap on focus, and create a new custom focus mode. For this video, I'm just going to name the new focus mode tutorial. I'm going to skip the notification settings and head down to customize screens. Choose whichever lock screen you want this focus mode to show, and this will set your wallpaper for this focus mode. Then, in the home screen option, select which page you want this focus mode to show. Now, when you have the focus mode turned on, only this page of icons and widgets will show up. I also take advantage of the focus filters here, so since I have a page set for dark mode, I will set the dark mode filter to apply whenever I turn on the corresponding focus mode. If you are setting up a dark mode focus filter for one of your modes, make sure to go to your other focus modes and set them to light mode so they automatically switch back. Once you've created all your focus modes, when you turn one on, you should see your wallpapers and home screen automatically change to whatever you selected. So that is all for this iPad customization video. I hope you found it helpful, and if you enjoyed it, I would appreciate you giving it a thumbs up, leaving a comment, and sharing it with your friends. Thanks for watching.